next topic, precipitation. Falling down of condensed water vapor in different form is called precipitation. So falling down of a condensed water vapor. So water vapor comes down into the earth surface in different forms. That one we called as a precipitation. When the dew point is reached in the cloud, water droplets become saturated and start to fall. Hence, they fall on the earth as precipitation. So, the climatic conditions, factors influencing to form a precipitation. What are the factors are influenced, stimulate the precipitations mainly. One is the temperature. The second one, altitude. Cloud type. Also, a cloud type is very important. Surface to the, near to the earth. So, cloud type. Atmospheric condition and precipitation process are important. The main form of precipitation includes, that is, the form of water vapor comes to the earth's surface is drizzle, rain, sleet, snow, hail, etc. So, what are the forms of precipitation include? Drizzle, rain, sleet, snow, hail, etc. So, first, drizzle. Falling of numerous uniform minute droplets of water. So, drizzle means falling of numerous uniform minute droplets of water with a diameter of less than 0.5 millimeter is called drizzle. So, very important. If rain means the drop diameter is 5 millimeter. But drizzle means the diameter of the droplet is 0.5 millimeter is called drizzle. From low clouds. Where it's come from? It's come from the low clouds. Sometimes drizzles are combined with the fog and reduce the visibility also. Next one, rain. Rain is the most widespread and important form of precipitation in places having temperature above the freezing point. It occurs when only when there is abundant moisture in the air. So, when rain will occur, only abundant of moisture in the air. So, the diameter of a rain drop is, so the diameter, the diameter of the rain drop is more than 5 millimeter. Next one, sleet. Sleet also the same, one kind of a precipitation, that is a water vapor comes to the surface of the earth, sleet. In the form of pellets made up of transparent and translucent ice. So, sleet is a transparent and translucent ice. This precipitation is a mixture of snow and rain. So, sleet is nothing but the mixture of snow and rain is called as a sleet. Snow as well as rain combined together we called as sleet. It look like transparent and translucent ice. Next one is a snow. Snow is formed when condensation occurs below freezing point. It is the precipitation of opaque and semi-opaque ice crystal. It look like opaque or semi-opaque. Oli pura tanmai. When these ice crystals collide and stick together, it becomes snow flakes. Last one, hails. Hails are chunks of ice greater than 2 cm in diameter. It's chunks, small pieces, chunks of ice falling from the sky. During a rainstorm or thunderstorm, hailstones are formed as solid precipitation. So, hailstones are formed of solid precipitation where small pieces of ice fall downwards. Alangatti Malai. So, hailstones are formed of solid precipitation where small pieces of ice fall downwards. These are destructive and dreaded forms of solid precipitation because they destroy agricultural crops and human lives.